basically because it thinks it already needs it, it should be okay just to rerun make here. And hopefully I won't get the error this time. Now the only slight problem is that obviously the configuration detected that there wasn't pulse audio, but the build later on needs pulse audio, so it could be that it's already built something without pulse audio, where it used what the configuration found, i.e. the correct state of affairs, so it's going to be a bit confusing, possibly, for the package. Well, that looks like something different, that bit there. Yeah, so the error hasn't occurred, so that's something interesting to make a note of, that pulse audio is definitely a requirement for QtWebEngine. Alright, so it looks like it's another started up another set of jobs, 871, so I'll come back when this bit's complete. Right, so at last that seems to have built successfully. So I'm going to install it now. Done. Such a short install with such a long build. We've got to remove some files here. And then to remove this Python link, which is the key to the package not building at all in the first place. So that's QtWebEngine done. It says if the user namespace is enabled, PID namespace must also be enabled. That's interesting, because user namespace is not enabled there, and yet it's saying if it is enabled to enable PID. So I'm not sure quite what should be set now. But let's have a quick look, see what we've got. PID is set, user is not set, so that's the same as what's on the screen, but not what the description says, so I'm a little bit unsure what to do with that. It does say that if user space is enabled, PID must also be enabled. What I think I'll do is look at the current development. I seem to be using this a little bit more and more now as a way to find out if there's been any known bugs or errors that have been added in that maybe aren't on the front page. So I'm going to go back to the main page and view development, and need to search for QtWebEngine and scroll down. Now it's the same. This package does not require any of the optional kernel namespace items. But if user namespace is enabled, PID namespace must also be enabled. In that case, enable the following options in the kernel configuration, recompiling if necessary. Well, PID is enabled and user is not enabled, and that's exactly what's here, so I'm going to leave it as it is. And if getting errors indicating that might be a problem, then I'm going to have to look at that again. Okay, so that's in X Libraries chapter 25. I'll mark that off. QtWebEngine to reinstall. So I've got lots of packages to reinstall.